Making it happen at the Great White Channel, that's all.
What a do, this is Great White making it happen again today with some more Portal Knights. We're taking another close look at the new update that's coming out, 1.4, with the creation mode. Today, what I thought we'd do is we're going to go ahead and take a look at all the new blocks and all the changed blocks that are being added with the creation mode. So I went through and what I did is I placed all of these. While I was on, I also placed all of these and all of these and all of these, and I'm going to do all of these as well. Now, I'll need to, I'm probably going to do a different video for each of these different categories, but I figured today we'd just go over the blocks. Now, this is going to be a lot of me talking about just the blocks and explaining some things, so just be ready for that. It's going to be real fun. So let's kind of start. First things first, this is actually a grass block. Yesterday I broke one, and I was like, I can't replace it. This is just a regular dirt, like grass, like dirt block. yeah, dirt block, so that was my bad. Pretty easy solution if you break one. You can just get in there and place a grass block. Hey, pro tip for you guys, if you are playing on PC, you can use shift click to add this to your inventory and remove it. I was having a hard time figuring that out yesterday, but I finally got it and it makes things much easier. Now, here's the first change block that we see. This is going to be the dirt or the soil block. This used to have like lines going through it, like it was like a farm soil, like there would be crops in it. They changed it so now it just looks like dirt, which I think is an awesome change. It looks a lot better, and if you guys haven't seen, maybe we'll pop over and check out the dirt in my home world, because it looks a lot better now as like a pathing block instead of like with those weird lines that used to look really strange. This is the sand block. I believe this is different now. It's a lot darker and a little more coarse looking than the old sand texture. The old one used to be a lot more just kind of like a yellow block. So pretty happy with how this one's turned out. I think it's a nice little look. This is the straw. I don't think there's been any change to that. The wood logs. This is the old, everybody's favorite, the refined wood block and the refined dark wood block. Those pretty much look the same. Refined bamboo. The coal. I think they changed the coal. I believe this looks different now. Take a close look at it, guys. I could be wrong. It's very possible that's the case, but from what I can tell, it looks a lot more, well, textured. It looks, it's a lot less, like, boring. It looks a little more, like, 3D. Like, you know, the coal's kind of sticking out, sort of. I don't know, it's a nice new texture. This is a snow block. I never found this in a playthrough. I don't know if this is new or not, but it's new to me. This is just a regular old snow block. I think it looks pretty cool. Here's your typical stone, yellow stone. This is our basalt stone, or bath salt stone, I like to call it. I think this is obsidian. Yeah, obsidian. Refined obsidian. This is celestial? Yeah, celestial stone and refined celestial. I don't think these changed. I never messed around with the celestial too much, but celestial looks super cool. I like it a lot. It's an awesome texture. I'll probably end up using that sometime soon. It's really cool. It looks kind of like tinfoil. That's interesting. Over here we got our first new block that wasn't in the game yet. So this is your roof tile block. The new one here is there's a dark roof tile block, which is super awesome. It's a really cool looking texture. Yeah, it's not super exciting, like it's not like really fancy or anything, but I think it's like a nice addition. Like I always thought there wasn't enough variety. I feel like all my roofs ended up being like red or this weird off red. It'll be nice having this new texture to use. It'll be a good addition. Here's our regular old stone. This is just the stone brick blocks. Now, the redstone brick blocks, that's what this one is. This is actually, I think they changed it. I could be wrong, but I think they did. Somebody can call me out if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure this is different now. I think the flooring, when it was a floor, it used to be a lot more like the edges, and now it looks more like the walls. The walls are super cool, too, and it looks like they have some variation in like the how deep of a red the different bricks are. So it looks, it's kind of, you know, has some variation. Here's our next new block that they added to the game. This one I'm pretty excited about. This one looks pretty cool. This is just the dark stone brick block. Is that what it is? Dark stone bricks block. God, the words. I like the refined dark wood block and then the stone dark brick block. They're super fun. So yeah, that's a cool block too. I'm excited to be using that one. That's actually pretty... a pretty nice looking block. I'll definitely be implementing a lot of that in my builds. This is just the runestone block, which I never messed around with too much. This is another good pathing block. This makes good, like, cobblestone pathing. I think it's a nice... I don't think they changed it. I could be wrong, though. Again, if you guys know if I'm saying anything incorrect, please correct me in the comments. I'd appreciate it. Over here is just your runestone. Here's the marble. I think the marble looks the same. Refined marble looks the same. Nothing changed there. This is our regular jade stone block, and then the refined jade stone. These I've used a lot more in my most recent build, which you guys will be seeing in the Season 2 premiere. Now, over here, we get into some of the crazy blocks. Check this out. So this one, this is just the... We've used these, the orange runestone and the red runestone. I've got these being used in my homeworld. This, I can't tell if it's because it's surrounded by all the other light sources, but it kind of looks a little bit different. It doesn't seem like the reds is as prominent as it used to be. I could be wrong about that, though. It may be the same. I'm not sure. Over here, though, the sunstone and moonstone blocks, I think is what these are called. Yeah, sunstone and moonstone. So I believe these two are actually the ones that you find in the world when you're going through dungeons, where if you break them, they'll give you a health potion or a mana potion. I think that's what these are. It's pretty cool they gave them to us to build with, because these ones don't really, these glowing, the runestone blocks, these ones don't, like, actually give off light very much, but these ones are super bright. They, like, you could light up a room with these things, which is a cool thing. I'm really happy they added these to be able to build with, because it'll be nice to have some additional lighting options. These are those asteroid blocks, I think. The electrocore block and then the asteroid core block. I didn't know this. I thought they were new, but apparently they've been around. Somebody told me in the last video, so thanks for correcting me. These have been around, but they're definitely very cool blocks. I kind of wish they were like the other ones where they have varying textures, so it's not just the same copied texture over and over again. Even so, it's still definitely a cool look, and I'll probably be using those some more too. If for nothing else than, like, cool lighting. This is the glowing sandstone. Yeah, the glowing sandstone block. This one's pretty cool, too. This one's been around for a while. We've had this one. I think you can get it from that the cult world. It's, like, one of the sand places where there's a cult that's, like, trying to get a mask of something. I'm not going to spoil the whole story for you, but, yeah, I'm pretty sure we've had this one for a while. Now over here we've got these blocks. These I don't have. I haven't used a whole lot of. These are the crystal blocks. We got just purple, dark blue, light blue, green, yellow, and red. Yeah, these. I mean, not a whole lot to say about them. I'm pretty sure they've been around a long time. I think they're crafting recipes is what they are. So they're pretty cool. I have used at least the green I know to go with the jade blocks in my most recent build. I think it's they're pretty interesting. They're kind of the thing about the colors they use a lot of, like, really bright, like, a really bright color palette in Portal Knights. Like, they have a lot of, like, just huge, like, I don't know, I'm not sure how to describe exactly what I'm trying to say. Like, the colors they have are really, like, prominent, and it's sometimes it's a little bit hard to get some that match together, which is why I'm really happy they started adding, like, the dark roof tile and, like, the dark bricks. Like, that, those are easier to mix around with, like, the wooden stuff. But when you get, like, these super bright colors, it's kind of hard to get them to mix together and get, like, a nice palette going when you have such a huge, like, difference in blocks. There's not as subtle. There's not as many, like, subtle differences between blocks, so it's kind of hard to mix them. But it seems like they're definitely taking steps in the right direction, so I really appreciate that. And I think they're doing a really great job with developing their textures. But, yeah, it's cool that they're still making progress on that and still, you know, updating and changing things. 505 Games is a really excellent, development company, game developer company. They're really good at what they do, and they're good at listening to the player base. But, yeah, sorry. Stop rambling now. Look at these are those, what are they called? They're, like, copper plate, iron plate, gold plate, and titanium plate. Yeah, these haven't been changed at all. These are all right. I've used them here and there in my builds. They're a little bit weird sometimes to get matched up, but I dig them. You gotta be careful with these titanium plate blocks, because when you're crafting, I was crafting and I accidentally crafted up a ton of these instead of titanium ingots, and this just wasted a lot of titanium. It was a very frustrating day for me. But over here we got the carpet blocks, purple, green, and yellow. These are so weird to use. Like, I've used them here and there in, like, buildings in front of, like, fireplaces and stuff. They're such a strange texture. They're so, I don't know. I almost would prefer it if they weren't textured and they just were, like, the color of the carpet and just had, like, well, you know, just didn't have the design on it. I could keep the texture. Like, that's cool. But if they just didn't have the design on it and were just the color, I think they would almost be better or easier to use. But this is another example where it's like they're just such extreme colors that it's hard to like mix them with different things. I wish they had more interesting light colors instead of just like here's purple and here's green and here's yellow. But whatever, I suppose I should figure out a better way to iterate what I'm requesting before I start making demands. looking over here, we got the different stones. So we've got our concretes rather. So you got gray, white, orange, red, green, light blue. Or that's just blue, and then there's deep blue. So, blue and then deep blue. So, these are pretty cool. The white, actually, I kind of prefer using that off-white one, the first one. They have the gray. This gray is more like just like an off-white. It's not very, I don't know, it doesn't seem super gray, but I really like this one. The white, it's all right in some examples, in some situations. I've used this one, I think I used it for my sails on my flying ship. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, there are definitely good uses for these. This orange one, I really like this orange one. It looks really good as another pathing block. It kind of looks like a dirt path, sort of. So I really like this one, but it doesn't sound like dirt when you walk on it. But, I mean, that's not a problem. It's just, I don't know, something interesting. I like it. I'd recommend you use it for pathing. That's what I think it looks like, but you guys obviously can interpret it how you will. Looking at this one, we got the red one. This is where you get from the pirate missions, and then, well, this is the first place you see it. I'm pretty sure you can craft it eventually. I could be wrong about that. And then we got the green, and then the blue, and then deep blue. Yeah, so those are definitely some good colors too. Now, we've got a lot going on as far as, like, other things, but I just wanted to show you guys all the new blocks. That's all of them that they have available. I didn't leave any out. Except the portal stones, but I can't really place those. If I try and place a portal stone, they still do the whole explodey thing, so I don't really know why they, didn't mean to do that. And they'll just disappear here in a second. Yep, there they go. I'm pretty sure, like, okay, so the next we'll kind of go over the benches and stuff, and then we'll get into the decoration things and probably tie in the NPCs with some of those, which I have all standing over there ready to go. So we'll kind of do those videos next, but I just want to show you guys this, and I want to correct myself on something I said with the previous video. We were kind of going through just a rough, scrolling through the different things we have available to us in creative mode. And somebody mentioned that there was like an alchemy table, and I was like, oh yeah, that's just aesthetic though, because it's like something you got from one of the missions. But I was wrong, and I want to correct myself and actually show you guys, because this is exciting news for the update. They told me I could talk about anything in the creation mode, so that's what I'm talking about. Over here we've got this alchemy table, and this is like there's four different levels to it, just like the other benches. And also something cool to point out here is that you guys know for the longest time, if you've watched my videos, I have like a whole intro thing dedicated to this, where I'm standing in front of a thing and I'm like, this thing is too large for me to use. It is not possible that I could actually use like this alchemy table or like this thing. And they actually fixed it. They changed it. They shrunk them down. They made them smaller. And it's actually pretty funny. Okay, sorry. Well, I'll actually show you something about that in a second. But yeah, here's the alchemy tables. I can't interact with them. I'm not allowed to interact in creative mode. So I can't like show you guys what it does. But I'm assuming it's going to be like the other crafting things, so we can like craft some kind of recipes in there. I mean, it's an alchemy table, so I would venture to guess that it's going to be different kinds of potions, but I don't know. It's pretty cool, though. I'm definitely very happy with the changes they made. It's definitely, it's coming along really, really nicely. And just look at all these decorative things we have. There's so many cool things to show you guys. I'm very excited to get to the next videos, too. But in the meantime, let's jump over to, I copied my Rainbow Island over to a creative world, so I can actually show you guys some of the changes over there. Because, I was worried some of the things that they changed might, like, not translate well in the world that I built. But actually, I feel like it turned out okay. Specifically, the pathing block, I think that actually looks much, much better now. And I'm very happy that they actually did this. It actually helped out quite a lot. So let's kind of do a little flying around here with the fruit knight. Let's see. So down here we can see here's the pathing that I used. Oh, that took damage. Weird. So yeah, here's the pathing. This is what I used for my farm. I think it looks good. I think it looks perfect. So it used to have like all the lines in it and stuff like we talked about. If we fly over here, this is my farm that I had going on, and the farm looks fine. I don't think it looks worse. I kind of liked how the other one looked better for the farm, but this isn't like bad by any means. I think it still looks good. Still looks like a farm. I kind of made the rows myself, so it's whatever. Other than that, though, oh, I also wanted to show you guys. Oh crap! I just revealed something that I've been working on. Oh no! Ooh, that was a little teaser for you guys. Sorry, I wasn't supposed to show you that. But let's go inside my little work area place here, my little base. Say hello to our cat. This little orange cat. See, look at this. These benches used to be like, I would say like 30% larger. They used to be like bigger. So I put them under the ground to help like make it look like they were at the appropriate height for me to use. And it's still kind of, oh no, it looks stupid now. So I'm going to have to fix these. Like they look silly being in the ground like that now. They look normal before. It looked like they were at the appropriate height. So I'm going to have to like fix that to make them look good again. But yeah, I thought, oh yeah, look at the fireplace too. Now the fireplace looks all weird. The fireplace, I guess it looks okay. You can get away with it. It looked a lot better before when it was larger. So it's kind of frustrating that it's changed now, and I'm going to have to go back and edit a bunch of stuff that I've done already. But I'm happy they made the change. I think it's a change for the better. But yeah. That's pretty much it, guys. That's all I wanted to show you for the day. I appreciate you coming and hanging out with me, and let me know what you think about the new blocks. Let me know what you think about the new textures. We're going to go again. We'll go through and check out all the other new stuff in the next videos, and then also, I'll go ahead and just let you know right now. I thought one other idea we could do is that with the map generation, if you guys want to, I thought this would be a cool thing. If you see like these generation options, like all these different choices, go ahead and like pause the video and you can like take note of them if you want, or I'll put them in the description or something. And if you guys see like one of these biomes that you want to see a procedural generation of, go ahead and like let me know in the comments. You can tell me, oh, show me like let's see a swamp that's on the shattered circle. I want to see a shattered circle swamp, and I'll go ahead and make one, and then we can fly over there and check it out, you know. So yeah, go ahead and let me know if you have anything you want to see with that. Let me know if you have any comments about the new textures. I thank you guys for coming and hanging out with me while we were checking this out. It's been a pleasure. Hit the like button if you liked the video. Leave a comment about any of that. And definitely subscribe if you guys haven't. We got more Portal Lines videos coming out here very, very soon. So stay tuned. And, well, you guys just have the best kind of day. See you later. Now I'm going to superhero fly off. Woo!